door just didn't open. But it slowly creaked open. She looked up. At least she thought she did. To see a man standing in her bedroom doorway. He was a tall, dark man, African-American man with bead-shaped gray hair on his head. Long, pointed nose and a pointed chin. A greasy face with high cheekbones. Head on a pair of gray slacks. And a light blue checkered shirt. He didn't even have a pair of shoes on. He looked at the doorknob and he saw a medicine bag. He showed it to her as she pulled the sheets above her nose and her mouth. As to be startled and almost frightened of the stranger that stood before her. He asked, "What is in this bag?" And she said slowly, with her shaking voice, reluctantly and with hesitance, "Bones." He took the bag and emptied it on her dresser, and he asked her, "Why are there nine of them?" She said, "Because the spirit told me I needed nine." At the drop of a hat, you could hear the confidence in her voice. He looked away from the bones and looked her in the eyes to see if he could find any morsel of fear. There was none. He calmly dripped sweat and he pointed his fingers and he wanted an answer. Why are there nine? She wouldn't give an answer. In the faint distance, there was a voice of a woman, and she said, "If this creeps you out, it means that the church is still within your body and your mind to create fear, and that energy that is produced will be utilized unbeknownst to you in any way that the spirit sees fit." She says, "I thought I was awake." The woman's voice said, "No, you are asleep." "Well, who is that man at the door?" "Suddenly he's no longer there," she said. "The number nine." He was the spirit that told me I need 9 bones. The faint female voice says, well, of course. But why would he question me and ask me, who told you to put 9 in the bag? The female voice says, well, you should know. He's quizzing you. He wants to know if you know who he is. But why do he want me to know who he is if he knows who he is? Well, go back to sleep and find out. Then you'll know.